Welcome, my peace, my peoples. Please like, comment, subscribe, share the video. It'd be greatly appreciated from the bottom of my heart, my peace, my peoples. So let's talk about Black Lightning. Black Lightning, season one, episode four. I believe it's called Black Jesus. Oh yeah, we got a Black Jesus. Anyways, happy, you know, Black History Month, Happy Heroes Month, Happy Power Month, all that good stuff, all that graviness going on. So let's get into, you know, we start off the episode with Black Lightning, you know, Jefferson, the principal or whatever. He goes into the bathroom. There's a kid that's acting up. There's a kid that's going wild, going crazy. He got some type of power. And guess what it is? He is on drugs. And so people then run out there to get, you know, Black Lightning, the principal, to tell him, hey, there's a kid out here that, you know, is out here on drugs. Not on drugs, but, like, he's acting up in the bathroom. There he is right there. So he's acting up in the bathroom. He's doing all that crazy stuff. Black Lightning goes in there and try to calm him down. But as the principal, Jefferson, you know what I mean, Jeffrey. So, you know, the kid starts coming at him. The kid, you know, picked up, you know, one of the toilet compartments or, you know, the stall or whatever and threw it at him or whatever. Black Lightning had to use his power. You know what I mean? He can use his power without his suit on. So that's also good to know as well. And so so as he's doing that or whatever, the kid, so he's got to, you know, that's Black Lightning right there. You know, he got to use his power. He's in the bathroom with this kid. So finally, he uses enough power, knocked the kid out. And then the kid, you know, he ends up finding drugs on the kid or whatever. So basically, the kid nearly overdosed. His name is Bernard. Bernard gets into a lot of trouble. Bernard stays in trouble. And so Bernard, you know, because there's this new drug called Green Lightning. A green light is called Green Light, and it's crazy because it's component with like crack, heroin, angel dust, or PCP. I think it's crack and PCP together. Basically, it's really strong and it's so addictive where it's really addictive. I guess they're trying to say it's really addictive because how it forms into your body and how it like clenches onto, you know, different transmitters in your body, and so it's very addictive. So that's why the first hit's for free. So they're talking about, you know, how when crack came out and all this other stuff. And then we also had the people that were smoking that synthetic weed and going crazy. So we got a little bit of that going on. And so anyways, you know, he takes care of that. And so then we get Jennifer. Jennifer's riding in her Mini Cooper or whatever. I think it's a Mini Cooper. And she's chilling. And she sees two of her students talking to these two gang members. And she pulls over. She gets out the car. And one of the girls said, look at her. Here comes Harriet Tubman. I was like, that is so wrong. But I laughed. I was like, yo, why you got to go there? Why you got to call her Harriet Tubman? But, you know, she's part of Black History Month. Anyway, so anyways, so she put the girls in the car. And she tells the boys, don't be trying to sell drugs. The boys was trying to sell Green Light to these young girls, and they all got to be like the ages from like 13 to like 16 or whatever. And so once Jennifer says to the boys, hey, listen, you know, don't be doing that. What's wrong with you? Don't you have a conscience? You're selling this poison to your own community. And the boy said, F you, bitch. Who you talking to, bitch? And then she was like, what? And he lifted up his shirt and he showed that he has the gat. He has a gun. Like some disrespectful motherfuckers. The girls are disrespectful. The boys are disrespectful. I was just like, And so the boy said, you heard me, bitch. I was like, oh, no. So anyways, he did that. And so, you know, Jefferson is, he's trying to find out, you know, what's going on with, you know, this green like drug or whatever. He's trying to get down to the nitty gritty. Who's actually running this? Who got these drugs on the street? And so basically he's trying to do an investigation. He thinks it's the 100 game. But, you know, Peter, which is Peter is, you know, his homeboy that knows his secret and help him with his equipment, thinks that, you know, it's something going on. They don't know who exactly it is because there's a bunch of overdose going on in the community. And basically, there's a lot of Black kids that are overdosing, and the media is not picking it up and they're not talking about it. So that is a problem. So that's a real big problem, too. So they're pointing it out, like when Black kids are dying or getting killed, it doesn't make the mainstream media, doesn't make the news and things like that. Because this is a Black drug, this is a Black area. And you know where Jefferson, where Black Lightning lives, is called Freetown. So it's supposed to be free. Niggas, we supposed to be free. So I guess that's what that mean or whatever. So so then after that, I was just like, So then we get Tobias. Tobias goes up there and he goes to meet up with, you know, Jill Scott. Jill Scott is Lady Eve, and basically Lady Eve is doing like an autopsy, or she's stealing some organs or whatever. I don't know if this goes back to Kanika Jenkins' case, you know, organ stealing and shit like that. And basically either doing an abortion or taking her organs. I don't know what she's doing. So, but Lady Eve is whatever. She is mad at Tobias right now. And she's upset with him. So basically, she's having a conversation with him, like, yo, what's going on? She's disappointed with him. And she's kind of like mad with him because, you know, basically, we find out that Tobias was a politician. And he was a politician that his career went wrong and went bad. He fell, he went underground. And then he ended up hooking up with the 100 gang. He ended up getting to lead the 100 game through Lady Eve and her peoples or whatever, because they believe that he killed Black Lightning. So now to come find out that he has not killed Black Lightning, like Black Lightning is still alive, you know, they want some answers, because now they don't have faith in him, because, you know, he got all his glory and his power because of, see, right there, she's doing some type of autopsy, right? Some type of sacrifice. That's, you know, Lady Eve, aka Jill Scott. So, he built his reputation and his career was built on being the one that killed Black Lightning. So basically, so Lady Eve is like, you know, your resume is faulty. Like, you know, you lied on your resume. That's what it is. And me and my partners are not feeling good about this. And we don't feel like we got trust in you or whatever. And so basically, they're saying you need to take, you know, Black Lightning out once and for all, because we ain't having this. And then she also says to him, because, you know, Tobias says, you know, what is he again? He's an albino. So he's albino. And so basically, she was telling a story about albino. She was like, back in the day, they used to believe that albino people were, you know, magical people. And what they used to do is cut them up, chop their bones up, and turn it into dust and sell it as magic dust or magic power or whatever. And she was like, you know, if you don't take care of Black Lightning, we're gonna have to, you know, cut you up, turn you into dust, and sell you as magical powder, basically. So she's just saying, like, yo, you better get it together. So Tobias is, you know, he's nervous. And Tobias was like, yo, I did math for you. I made millions and millions of dollars. I just made one mistake. She was like, well, you made too many mistakes. You know, shot a boy that went to the You shot a boy, you know, he was supposed to be going to the Olympics. And then Tobias, like, he really wasn't gonna go to the Olympics. Yes, well, they believe not now. So now he's paralyzed. The Reverend's been shot. Lawanda got killed. And so, and then Black Lightning's back. They're losing confidence in him, and he better get it together, or they're gonna take him out. So, anyways, you know, moving on from that, she was like, your resume is faulty. When she said, we'll turn you into dust, and she continued. And then when, you know, Lady Eve was doing like some type of autopsy or taking this girl's organs, you know, the girl woke up in the middle of the process. So she wasn't even under anesthesia. Like, yo, that is torture. Lady Eve is evil, you know, on the show. So, and I don't know why they call her Lady Eve. So it's like, damn. And so, you know, I was like, that girl done woke up on the table. And so then basically now the kid that, you know, got all messed up in school, you know, Bernard, that was all high or whatever. Basically, he's at the principal office. He's at, you know, Black Lightning's office as the principal, aka Jefferson. He's there with his father and everything. And basically, he's about to get expelled. So Black Lightning is going to, you know, try to make sure he doesn't get expelled, try to use his power and his influence to get this kid to stay into school, whatever. So the kid looks nice. The kid looks calm. The father's there, whatever. And they're begging for him not to be expelled. You know, Jefferson is gonna do whatever thing he can to keep, you know, Bernard in school. But Bernard, it looks good. Everything looks good. But he was like, yo, I need to know where you got, you know, the green light from. And so, you know, Bernard tells him that he got it from this guy named Two-Bit or whatever, Blase the Third. So boom, they go. And so then that's when, you know, Black Lightning was like, okay, I know who Two-Bit is. So he calls. I think he said he got it from 2Bit, right? So he calls 2Bit. I think I'm messing up somewhere. No. So the kid said he got the drugs from Ronald Cage or whatever. And so, so Ronald Cage or whatever. So then he calls, you know, Peter, you know, his AKA partner or whatever. And Peter goes, well, you know, Bernard gave me some information, and the guy name is Ronald Cage or whatever. And then Peter was like, well, Ronald Cage is drug is dead right now. And he was like, you know, because they find out that he's selling, you know, the black light, you know, green light. He's selling green light or whatever. And so then this is when Peter goes, you know, he forgot the number one rule as a drug dealer: don't get high off your own supply. So that was a Biggie lyric to me. Well, you know, the 10 crack commands: don't get high off your own supply. So anyways, I was like, okay, Peter, like, okay, we're throwing Biggie in there too, right? So anyways, so Ronald Cage, he's dead, so they can't get any information from him. But you know, Black Lightning goes out on the street. He do some investigation because these drugs are all over the place. People are ODing a lot. So he's doing some investigation, and he's out there as Black Lightning. So, you know, Black Lightning pulls up on one of the drug dealers, you know, beat him up a little bit and asks him for some information. He gives the information that, you know, the person that he got, the person that's giving him the drugs to sell or whatever, his little connects as Two-Bit. So Two-Bit, whatever. And we find out that Black Lightning knows him. Black Lightning went to school with him and all this other good stuff. So he knows who he is. So he's going to go check him out. But Peter really thinks there's something big going on because these drugs are just moving too fast and they're all over the place and everything like that. And it's kind of, you know, a little bit too advanced for the 100, they believe. So anyways, I was like, damn. He was like, yeah, so, you know, Black Lightning was telling Peter, yeah, I grew up with 2-Bit or whatever, Blase the Third, this and that. So anyways, you know, Black Lightning goes to see, you know, 2-Bit or whatever. He goes to the bar or whatever, and he sits down, 2-Bit sees him, they talk, you know, they do a little bit of greeting. And then Jefferson was like, yo, I heard the cops are going to be coming after you because you're supposed to be, you know, you're selling that green light, whatever. So I think you should stop selling it, Blase the Third or whatever. And then this is when 2-Bit was like, no, I'm not going to stop selling. I'm not going to stop selling drugs or whatever. I need to feed my family. I got to do what I got to do, my friends, you know, whatever. So peace, homie, deuces. So anyways, Tobias, I mean, 2-Bit is still going to sell drugs. But, you know, 2-Bit was like, oh, you know what? Thank you, Jefferson, for the warning. It's all good. Thank you. I appreciate it. And so now, you know, Jefferson, Black Lightning, don't know. He's like, damn, so I got to come at him hard. And so anyways, he's talking to Peter. They're trying to get a warrant to get him arrested, get him off the street or whatever, because they think for some reason he is the mutual connect to a lot of the drug dealers in the community that where the kids are doing the ODing at. So they realize that the warrant ain't gonna work. It's gonna take too long. So then he was like, you know what? I'm gonna go see him as Black Lightning. So Black Lightning gets up and goes sees him at the bar, beats up all the guys at the bar, doop, doop, psh, 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 beat him up, doop, doop, you know, let him go. And so then 2-Bit is trying to run out, and 2-Bit got long dreads. Like, where are you running with them long dreads? So then the Black Lightning gets him. Black Lightning is telling him, like, you need to stop selling these drugs or whatever, and blah, blah, blah. Tell me who's your source. And then the dude was like, yo, and I can't tell you my source because you know what you're going to do? You're going to knock me out and have the cops coming to get me. I'm going to face 30 years in prison. You know, they're always trying to lock a brother up and give him more time, you know. And so he kind of plays on, you know, Black Lightning's, you know, heart, you know. You know what I mean? And plus, Black Lightning does know 2-Bit because he went to school with him. They grew up together, whatever, but he's a little bit younger than Black Lightning. So he was like, well, then I'm not going to call the cops, but you need to tell me this. You need to tell me where you get it from, all this other stuff. And so 2-Bit tells me, you know, I pick it up on this street, that street, whatever. I think he said he picks it up on the 389th Street, something like that. He picks it up on the street or whatever, and he meets at this spot, this and that, blah, 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 and all this other stuff. And so, so 2-Bit is, you know, snitching and whatever. And so then 2-Bit's about to get away, but he was like, yo, I want to take a picture with you. So he runs to try to take a selfie with, you know, Black Lightning, whatever. And he was like, make sure you do all that flashing and stuff. And Black Lightning's like, what? He's taking a picture too. Black Lightning just punched him and knocked him out. But I guess Black Lightning didn't call the cops on him or whatever. But damn, he was like, I want to get a picture. Why would he want to get a selfie? If Tobias finds out he got a selfie with Black Lightning, he's dead off rip. So I don't even know why 2-Bit want to do that. But 2-Bit got punched in the face because he was acting too fanishly. He was acting like a super duper fan. And so anyways, that situation is all right. And so then We got, you know, Tobias. Tobias goes to see the doctor that actually, claimed that Black Lightning was dead, because supposedly Black Lightning fell into the river. He fell in the water. Nobody could survive that fall. And then basically the body was, supposed to have been cremated. So when Tobias goes sees, the doctor, whatever, he finds out the doctor didn't do what he was supposed to do. It was another body. It wasn't Black Lightning's body. And, he didn't even see the body. He didn't identify the body, whatever. So boom. That now he knows Black Lightning is alive. So then, Tobias is upset, and so he makes sure the doctor gets beat to death with brass knuckles. And they got some harsh beatings in this show, especially that girl on a table with Lady Eve. I'm like, damn. And so then, we have, what's her name? Jennifer, she's chilling. She's meeting up with, Grace now, because now she's single, but now she knows she has power and all this other stuff. And basically, they sit down and have a family dinner. So we got we have, Inspector Henderson. He does not like Black Lightning, but he doesn't know that he's best friends with Jefferson, which is Black Lightning. So he's always saying something negative about Black Lightning being a vigilante. He causes more harm than good. And so you got Jennifer. She's talking about Black Lightning as a hero. He's wonderful. I wish he can do more. And then that's when Lynn jumps in, was like, well, he got a family, and it's probably this, it's probably that. So that's when Jennifer jumps in and said, you know what? I guarantee you, Black Lightning family gotta support him, gotta have his back. Why wouldn't they not support him? He's a hero. He's this, he's that. And so, Black Lightning, aka Jefferson, he's feeling that, he's liking that. And she was like, I wish I can do more, I wish I can stop these criminals, whatever. But she's so hyped and so super and so different about the situation. Like, her hair is wild. She's just like, she's out of it. Like, she's just focusing on, fighting bad guys. And so, anyways, when so she's like, no disrespect to you, Henderson, inspector, police officer, but y'all ain't doing nothing, really. Y'all ain't doing nothing. And so then basically, then we find out that, Khalil, he's not gonna walk again. He's going to be paralyzed. He's going to be paralyzed forever. And so it is what it is with that situation. And I was like, damn, he's gonna be paralyzed. So with him being paralyzed, his girlfriend, I mean, no, see, I'm getting it wrong, Nessa. Nessa is the one with the power. Nessa is the one that is the teacher. Nessa is the one that pulled over the drug dealers and beat them up. Nessa is the one that is dating the, no, is talking to Grace or whatever. And Nessa is the one that basically dissed, Inspector Henderson, and actually, giving, Black Lightning, props, and her father is listening to it. But Jennifer's acting real different, because now she knows she has power, and she really wants to fight crime, and she really wants to save people and this and that. So, Jennifer, she goes back. So she excused herself, not Jennifer, Nessa, she excused herself from the dinner table. And once she excused herself from the dinner table, she goes to find them young boys that was talking shit and called her a bitch and said, bitch, what you looking at? She finds them, and then she punched them, and she was like, who you calling a bitch now? I was like, go Nessa, go Nessa. And so Nessa is just like, she's, that's kind of vengeance right there. And maybe that's not, 'cause she's just new to her power and all that other stuff. And so she realized that she really hurt these boys. So she's just like, oh shit. So she called 911 to save them, to make sure that they're all right and everything. But we have Jennifer. So Jennifer is with Khalil, and basically, she's not paying attention to, her sports and stuff like that, because she's standing by Khalil right now. And the parents is like, yo, this is way too much for you to be doing. You're taking too much on. You've been through a lot, whatever. I need you to, stop kind of like seeing Khalil every day, and focus on, track, whatever. She wants to quit track and all this other stuff. And plus, she feels guilty. Then when she was at, the hospital with Khalil, the nurses was talking about him or whatever, and saying like, I don't know why that girl's acting like, she's gonna be with him, and all this other stuff, and like, why is she playing around with him, and that boy ain't gonna never walk again and all this other stuff. And so it's sad to see that. Damn, Khalil was supposed to be in the Olympics. But anyways, the news reporters want to interview Khalil and about his story. So they interview him and all this other stuff. And so I'm just like, damn. It's like, and but Khalil, he's gonna eventually change, you know what I mean? Because he's gonna end up because Tobias, he has a new girl. He has a friend that comes to see him, and I believe her name is Tracy, but we'll get to that. And so and so I was just like, damn. So they find out that the drugs is really, 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 really addictive and shit like that. It's really, really addictive. And now we know Khalil's not gonna walk again. And then, you know, then what's his name? Bernard, he actually gets saved. You know, the principal, you know, Principal Jefferson's actually able to keep him into school, and all this other stuff. So everything's supposed to be good with that. And then we get to see Tori. Tori's coming into town. She's in this nice whip or whatever. She goes to see Tobias. And basically, she's there to help Tobias take out Black Lightning to kill him, because, you know, Tobias can't go to Freeland because he got too many warrants. So whoever this Tori is, she must know a lot about Black Lightning, or maybe she can get close to him. But now she is going to be coming to kill Black Lightning to help Tobias. And then Tobias, you know, he's feeding his animals these big-ass rats. What kind of animals that swim eat rats? Well, anyways, it was disgusting. That and water. And so basically, then that's when the interview of Khalil comes on TV talking about, you know, he was supposed to be in the Olympics or whatever. And that's when Tori was like, you know what? You know what we can do? We can turn the community against Black Lightning, like Spider-Man and all this other stuff. And then that's the way to get to Black Lightning as well, because he's trying to save the community. But if we turn the community against him, then he's not going to be able to, you know, it's probably going to push him back in the shadow, then they can get to him. So they're going to use Khalil. So, you know, Tobias goes to buy Khalil sneakers, you know, video games and all that stuff, paying the rent, helping his mom pay the rent, paying his medical bills. So now they're probably going to lose Khalil's platform, you know, with his interview and getting on the media and talk about how bad Black Lightning is, you know, to stir the community to turn against Black Lightning, to come after him so Black Lightning can't creep in the streets. It makes no sense. But, you know, Khalil got all these sneakers and stuff. We're going to use another Biggie lyric. All a nigga shoes and clothes is all a nigga knows. Hoes, clothes, and shoes, all a nigga knows. And just like, that was one of Biggie lyrics. And it's like, this boy got all these sneakers. I was like, come on, you guys. Then you said Biggie lyrics early in the show. So this is what I'm thinking. They're buying him all them sneakers. He got Jordan sneakers, all shoe boxes. Just a mess. But anyways. So they're going to be using Khalil to do that or whatever. And also, you know, Jennifer, she's not feeling too good, because when she told Khalil that she was quitting soccer, you know, track or whatever, to spend more time with him, he acted like it was no big deal. So he's not, because he's really focused on his injury. And so now we see that he's going to be turning against Black Lightning. And we know Jefferson is Black Lightning. So it's going to be some type of, you know, issue with that. And then also, we find out that his spinal cord is severed, so Khalil's never going to walk again. So that's going to give him more ammunition to dislike and not like Black Lightning at all. So we're going to be seeing that coming. We're going to see his relationship with Jennifer probably be a demise between him going after Black Lightning and speaking negative about Black Lightning probably next episode. And the father not going to want, you know, Jennifer around Khalil at all. And so we know that, you know, Tobias, he goes to see, you know, Khalil and tried to talk Khalil into hating Khalil to hate Black Lightning and all this other stuff, you know, and basically go after Black Lightning. I was like, damn. And plus this kid got a mouthpiece, and you know that, you know, Tobias has a lot of people that work in regular businesses and regular community leaders and people that are in the government that would give him camera time and all that other stuff. I'm like, damn, it's going down. So anyways, then we have Black Lightning. Black Lightning's able, Peter invented something new for Black Lightning where he's able to have x-ray vision. He can sense body heat, he can see through things, so he has x-ray vision. And now he finds out where the drugs are being located. They're being stored at a warehouse. They're like all types of ops, you know, protecting the shipment. They have tractor trailer trucks, 18 wheelers out there with barrels. It's a very sufficient, you know, process going on with, importing and distributing these drugs, and they don't think it's just the 100. No, it's not the 100, because we know Lady Eve has partners. So, anyways, we'll see what happens. And I wonder if Tobias, since he's albino, knows talking about that magic dust, is there any magic powers that he does have? Because he did pick up, Lala with his one hand and choke him to death. So we'll see. And that's Black Lightning being able to see with X-ray vision, and that's like the drug going on. It's all protecting and shit like that. But then in the meantime, in between time, Nessa is leaving the bar with, Grace, the new girl that she's chilling with, and some dudes come up and try to, assault Grace because they're against lesbians. And then they hit Grace, and then, Nessa, she ends up firing back, and she's stomping. She's getting upset, and she's stomping on the ground, and she's breaking the cement and holes or whatever. And Black Lightning can hear this because he's almost right on top of the bar of the building, or like a couple of buildings away. And that's when he was like, "No, I'm just gonna go check on, where that noise is coming from. Somebody could be hurt." And Peter's like, "No, Gambit or whatever." He's like, "No, just watch the truck, follow the truck so we can know where it's going." He was like, "No, innocent people could be hurt or whatever." So then, he tells Peter to look. So Peter goes to look, and he sees someone with a hoodie on their face stomping and breaking the cement, punching people and throwing them in the air and shit like that, because this is what, Nessa is doing because she has power. She used her breathing and her anger, and she can go right into it. So when Peter went to go look, the camera, like, he saw her walk around the car and stomp the ground. And I don't know if he knew that was Nessa or not. I don't know if he could identify that Nessa's PT Cruiser was parked. I think her car was there or whatever. And but Nessa, after she beat up the guy, she's inside the bar. And so it's like, Peter doesn't say anything to Black Lightning about this going on because he doesn't know exactly what it is. I wonder if he knows if it's Nessa or not, or he thinks there's somebody else with power. But also with the green lightning, the drugs, it seems like the kids have power using that drug where they're able to pick up, take, toilet and stalls in school and rip it out of supply. So maybe that drug has some type of, is gonna equip somebody with some power before they get, I don't know, addicted. I'm just thinking. So anyways, so Black Lightning goes back to, watching the truck, or he goes to see if he can catch up with the truck. And that's when Pete, or he's gonna go home and rest. And that's when Peter, he goes out there to check what was going on. He take pictures. So and he had a shotgun. So if he knew it was Nessa, why would he carry a gun? So I'm assuming he doesn't know it's Nessa. He's just in shock that somebody else with power. I guess he's gonna see how he's going to, find out who it is, because the cameras did die out. So but I wonder if he can get the cameras back to before, the cameras faded out because Nessa was hitting the ground. And I don't know if he's ever gonna get back to the picture of Tobias, because when Tobias did the shooting, he had an image of Tobias, and it's been deleted. I wonder if Peter can ever get that footage back so they can know who to, so they know Tobias is coming for him. So I'm just like, damn. And so it seems like Khalil, he's caught up in his injury, he's caught up in what's going on with him, that he's not really focusing on, Jennifer. And Jennifer just needs to fall back, but I think their relationship is going to be over soon, and he's going to be the most peace for Tobias. So anyways, I'm just like, damn. So I don't know if it was a good idea. I think it was a good idea for, Nessa to use her powers, but to make all that noise, stumping and drawing that attention. Hopefully she knows that next time that's not a good thing, because she drew a lot of attention to herself by doing that, making that noise where her father and Peter is on the scene. But I would like for them to know that she does have power. That would be cool. So we'll see what happens. But that was like, damn. So whoever this lady Tracy is, I guess she's a mastermind, and she's really smart or whatever. She's able to handle getting to, Black Lightning. But I wonder if they have any power, And I heard that Jennifer's supposed to have power too as well. All the, it's supposed to be Black Lightning, Jennifer and Nessa, they all supposed to have power. So we'll see. But anyways, that kid Bernard that, Black Lightning was trying to help. His father ends up calling Black Lightning, you know, bleeding and shit like that. That's when Nesta beat up and see that boy throwing toilets. This is what the drugs do to you, making you that type of power. But what if it gives some, what if it activates some power in somebody else where, I don't know, they have power all the time, only if they take the drugs. They can make it like that, I guess. So anyways, you know, Bernard's father calls, you know, Jefferson and lets him know that, oh, you know, Bernard went out to go get some more green light, and then when he did, you know, I tried to go save him and they beat me up or whatever. And so then that's when, you know, Black Lightning shows up at the drug house, you know, beat the drug dealers up, save Bernard, put Bernard in a rehab or whatever. And you know, and this is the same time that Jefferson is going back to back for Bernard, trying to keep him in school and losing some power and then gaining some power at the same damn time. So he's safe. But I just wonder, like, you know, do none of these people putting two together after they tell Principal Jefferson something, miraculously their problems are solved, like he goes and get people and he rescues them. Or he turns into Black Lightning, like you tell him something, boom, he's already got it solved. Oh, he's asking these questions, and then he's interviewing these people, he's asking them these questions. Next thing you know, he goes to see these people. So it's just like when he went to go see 2-Bit, you know, he went to go see 2-Bit, warn him about the cops, and then right after that, Black Lightning comes and see him. Like they don't know, they're not putting it together that possibly, you know, Jefferson is Black Lightning. So anyways, peace. I'm out. Please like, comment, subscribe, share the video. It'd be greatly appreciated from the bottom of my heart, my peace, my peoples. Peace. I'm out. One love.